Hi guys, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Anybody who gets started with Android and activity will have a understanding that activity has a life cycle. So when you start an activity, it will go through certain methods which are called as callback methods. And some of those methods get called more often than other methods. There is nothing more to it and you probably already know this. But in this video, we will be mainly concentrating on the fragment. There is no prizes for guessing that even fragment has certain lifecycle methods. It is very important to understand in which order these lifecycle methods get executed. And is there any correlation between the lifecycle methods of the activity and the fragment? So we shall understand this through a demo. I'm working with the same old code. It's just that I have added some of the lifecycle methods of the activity. As you can see, these are the lifecycle methods of the activity. And if you go back to the fragment also has some of the lifecycle methods. For us, it is important that we understand in which order these methods are getting executed. We will learn it through observing the logcat. And let me add main activity as the filter in the logcat. So it is on create, on start, and on resume. And when I close this, it is on pause, on stop, and on destroy. There is nothing new to this. But however, if I add sample, it is these methods that are also getting executed. So let me run this again so that you understand in which order these got executed. So let me open this and you will observe that on attach, on create view, on activity created, on start, and on resume. And all these are methods from the fragment. And the fragment is now visible. So that is why the last method is on resume of the fragment. And when I close the activity and also the fragment that is attached to the activity, these are the methods, that is on pause, on stop, on destroy view, on destroy, and on detach. So these are the orders of the method execution independent of activity and the fragment. But what is the correlation between the lifecycle methods of the activity and the fragment? So for that, let me use the common tag in the main activity and the fragment so that we can do a filter based on this particular tag. So let me rerun this. Now you should observe with the onCreate activity, it is onAttach, onCreate, onCreateView, and onActivityCreated method get executed. And then there is a correlation between onStart of the activity and the fragment. And then you execute the onResume of the activity and then the onResume of the fragment. And when I close this, once again observe the correlation. So when I close this, onPause of the fragment, and then the on pause of the activity, on stop of the fragment, and on stop of the activity, and then the remaining three methods of the sample fragment, that is on destroy view, on destroy, and on detach, that get executed, and then finally the main activities on destroy method get executed. However, one of the questions that might come to your mind is, what if the activity already exists and then the fragment is added? On create, on start, and on resume would have already got executed. And if you add the fragment later, then what happens? Is there any kind of correlation at that time between the lifecycle methods of the activity and the fragment? Let's see that. So right now, the fragment is getting added to the main activity immediately in the lifecycle method of the onCreate. So what we will do is, we will have a button here in the activity layout, and on click of this particular button, I want to launch the fragment. So let me go back here and uncomment some lines which I have written already, and this particular add fragment method now gets called inside the onClick listener of the button add fragment. So let me rerun this now. So as you can expect, since I have not added any fragment, no methods of the fragment get executed. And when I click on this particular button, it is now the onAttach, onCreate, onCreateView, onActivityCreated, onStart, and onResume get executed. So if you think that there is a very tight coupling between onStart method of the activity and onStart method of the fragment, and it is onStart method of the activity that triggers the onStart of the fragment, that is not like that. They can work independently of one another also. This makes it very clear that there is some relation, but it is not very tightly coupled correlation. And now when I close this, once again, since the fragment is already added, you will observe that there is a correlation correlation between the lifecycle methods when the screen is getting closed. Just to make fragment getting closed independently of the activity, I will comment out this particular line. What this basically does is, if I hit the back button, instead of closing the activity, it will just remove the fragment. We will be understanding this in a much more detailed manner later, but let us see what happens with this code. So activity lifecycle methods got executed. I will add a fragment. Fragment's lifecycle got executed. And if I remove, only the fragment gets removed. So only the fragment's lifecycle method got executed. And now if I once again hit the back button, it is the only activity's lifecycle that get executed. So I think this should make it very clear in terms of how the lifecycle methods of activity and fragment work. Now the question is, why is it so important that you understand this? It is important because sometimes you may want to access something that is there in the activity from the fragment. So if you don't know in which particular state the activity is, then you may try to access something from the activity when activity is not there or activity is in the wrong state. So during our upcoming videos in the fragment, we will be writing a lot of code which is actually influenced by this concept and determines why we write a particular code in a particular lifecycle method of the fragment. So stay tuned. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.